Hi, Birdie Brigade. We're here on our back porch in Texas on a gorgeous Sunday afternoon. Hope all of you are doing well. Einstein's doing some acrobatic moves. Hello, Hannah. All the Birdie Brigade people are here, Einstein. Isn't that cool? They're here to see you talk. Hey, everybody. Okay, Einstein's gonna go over there now. All right. Before we get started, I just want to say that, I'm just trying to figure out where he's going to go. I just want to say that we've got some Merry Corn shirts online, so be sure and get your two new designs are up, and you can find them in the link below. They are two new Merry Corn designs for this Christmas holiday season. For those of you who don't know, Einstein says Merry Corn, and that's his multicultural, politically correct holiday greeting. Isn't it, Einstein? Merry Corn. And he's also working on the words Birdie Brigade. He's doing a very good job getting that down. He is saying Birdie Brigade. Brigade. Something like that. So maybe he'll say it out here. I don't know. He's pretty shy about it, but let me see what else. Oh, I also made him some pumpkin spice treats. They're bird treats for him, and he just loves them. And I'll post the recipe for that down below, too, when this is published and on YouTube, when we stop going live. So anyway, he's climbing all the way to the ceiling. Oh, Einstein, you are so silly. You gonna come back down now and do some talking? Okay, so now I'm gonna hush up and I'll go back inside and he'll do some talking, hopefully. He's had his lunch. Okay, Einstein, we'll see you later. I'll see you later. You do some talking, okay? I love you. Do some talking. I'm going to back the tripod up because he might try to fly to it. Okay, see you later, honey. Bye-bye. Do some talking.
chicken.
Come here.
Come here.
Yeah.
hair. You're so sweet. Sweet. Sweet.
Hungry? nothing up there, honey. There's nothing up there. Hi, everybody. I've been getting a lot of questions. I've been reading them, but I'm not such a good typer on the iPad. Jeff's on the computer. He's catching them as he can. I appreciate that. I just want to say that if you consider getting a parrot, please do your research. These are not easy creatures to raise. They do require a lot of time, a lot of patience, and a lot of money. They have to go to a special kind of a vet, an avian veterinarian, and those are sometimes hard to find. Having a parrot is also a life-changing process. And life-changing process. Anyway, what I'm trying to say is that your life will never be the same. They live a very long time. They live to be 40, 50, 60 years old. And you're responsible for them for the rest of their life. Einstein's 20. We hope to have him at least another 10 or 20 years, but you never know what happens, and he'll someday have to be rehomed. And anyway, just please do your research. Don't take that decision lightly. If you have any other questions, please put them in the comments after this video gets processed. YouTube will process the live version, and it'll go on his regular YouTube channel. One question I remember seeing, what's Einstein's favorite food? I always say anything we're eating. He's a big mooch. He likes to eat whatever we're eating, but his favorite food is probably pastas and breads. He loves corn and eats vegetables, carrots, broccoli, all the foods that he talks about he really likes, sweet potatoes. Okay, Einstein. Oh, and one of the reasons why he was flying on the swing, somebody asked that question, why is he flapping? Actually, I think he wants to come in. He wants, see, he settled down now that I came out here. I think he just wants, what'd you do, Einstein? Did you go bombs away? Yeah, you went bombs away. I think he just was getting tired and wanted to come inside. But now he seems to be happy again. Oh, and tune in next week for sure, because we're going to be carving a Halloween jack-o'-lantern. I bought a pumpkin today, and so I'm going to let Einstein carve his jack-o'-lantern. That will be fun. We'll be in the kitchen. I'm not going to mop my floor until after we do that, because it makes a mess. Yeah, don't laugh, Einstein. That'll be next week. Oh, and everybody's been asking me about a Halloween video. I'm trying to get one made. A certain actor, and I won't mention any names, but his name's Einstein, has not been cooperating very much with that, but I'm hoping to get something put together. It will might be short, but it'll be a Halloween video. Now he's knocking his head on the ceiling. That silly bird. Get back down here. You don't need to be going up there. I know. You can come down. You gonna shake? Shake it. Shake it, yeah. Yeah, he sure has been energetic today. You want to come back down now? Oh, Jeff showed up. Hi, Jeff.
Show him how we go alley-oop.
Well, wait just a second. I can't see on here very well. Okay, there you go.
Okay, there you go. Let's show him that you're willing to be upside down with me sometimes. Here we go. Oh, good bird. There you go.
Hi, Jeff. Oh, there's Sydney. Hi, Sydney. That's the dog in the backyard. It's not our dog. It's our neighbor's dog, our backdoor neighbor. Hi, Sydney. Is that Sydney? There's a video. Gosh, I forgot what it's called right now, but it's about Sydney poking his nose through the hole in the fence. If you scroll through the videos, you'll see the thumbnail. I think it's something like the dog next door or something like that. Okay, I'm going to step back inside, see if he'll start talking again. If he does, we'll continue. If not, we may have to say goodbye. So, Einstein, do some talking. A little bit more talking. I'll see you in a minute. Okay, it looks like Einstein wants to preen now. Doesn't want to talk anymore. There was one comment about Einstein picking his feathers. Yes, we're aware of that. He started that about last year. And parrots pick their feathers for a variety of reasons. One of them is behavioral, another is habitual, and a third is medical. We've had Einstein checked by an avian vet. He's perfectly happy, or healthy. He's happy and healthy. We believe it's just a habit. He's always been a downy picker, but now he's starting to pick his gray feathers on his chest. And we're not happy about it, but we're not getting stressed out about it either. There's no shame in picking. I just want to say that. We're not ashamed of it. It just happens. Birds do it for a variety of reasons. We're doing everything we can to have him not do it. However, he only does it at night. He's never picked his feathers in the daytime. He only does it at night in his cage when he's supposed to be sleeping. So we're not drawing any attention to it. One of the recommendations people tell you to do is just, you know, ignore it. Well, that's easy for us to do because we never see him do it. Don't draw attention to it, and yet he continues to do it. So right now he's just preening, though, and there's a difference between preening and picking. And we're, like I said, we're aware of it. He gets annual blood work done by a very good avian vet in Dallas. So, and if your bird picks, just take them to an avian vet. Make sure they're healthy. Otherwise, just love them. And like I said, there's no shame in picking. Parrots do it for a variety of reasons. And that's all I'm going to say about that. Okay, we're going to call it a day. Einstein's happy as a lark out here. It's a beautiful day. And we're going to wish all of you a wonderful, wonderful week. Enjoy life wherever you are in this world. And we will talk to y'all again next Sunday at 2, and we'll be in the kitchen and we'll be carving our Halloween jack-o'-lantern. So see y'all then. Bye-bye.